Howdy, how's it going? My name's Davy Chappie, and it's time for another UA released 1 week later than expected.
I'm watching you, Jeremy. I expect big things.
To bring us back to an old group of subclasses donning a new coat of paint in the form of the Phantom Rogue replacing the Revived Rogue, the Genie Warlock losing its noble status, and the Order of Scribes Wizard, which exists because the design team took one look at the Artificer subclass and decided that no, we can't have nice things. As always, keep in mind that a lot of this is just my opinion, so if you feel like Unearthed Arcanas are simply propaganda that give false hope to the hopeless, then feel free to play your games however you want. But with that out of the way, let's begin. So, starting out, we got the Phantom Rogue, a sneaky boy that embraced the Edge and became one with the Dark Side, granting them necromantic powers that helped them teach other people about the Dark Side by means of stabbing them over and over and over and over and over and over. And as a Phantom, you can summon the spirit of a ghost to teach you how to be good at a skill or a tool. You can cause the spirits to scream at people when you deal damage to deal more psychic damage to the second person. You can absorb someone's soul into a tiny trinket that you can then use to ask them where they left the TV remote. You can walk through walls, disappear, and fly, and eventually you can get your ghost to scream at more people like it's a quarantine and they need to get their hair done. As is going to become a staple of these subclasses, the Phantom Rogue is almost good to go, but it's got just a little bit more going to get to. I like the Wails from the Grave, although I think it's weird that it scales off of proficiency bonus, a belief that, again, you're going to see a lot of in this UA. And the only real change that I would make ability-wise is that I would swap out the ability to turn into a ghost with the extra damage ability, because not only is getting a bit more extra damage at 17th level sort of underwhelming, but being able to be much more unique than the other guys is something that you should not be able to accomplish so early into the game as 13th level. Destroying the DM's dungeons by bypassing all of the walls should be the reward for a long campaign, not the mid-level checkpoint, lest we find more DMs that want to go ghost. Moving on, the Genie Warlock has apparently done some unscrupulous things since the last UA, seeing as it is no longer a noble, and it can often be found living out of a cardboard genie lamp. In a pleasant surprise, the Noble Genie's abilities change depending on what flavor of gin you want to have, giving you a universal subclass spell, as well as one that is tied to your genie specifically. You also gain a new hat trick in the form of taking your genie repository and using it as a makeshift hotel room, which means that you can suck yourself up into it and chill out for an hour. The vessel can break now, though, so be careful. Beyond that, you get extra damage based on your proficiency, with the type being tied to your djinn. You get resistance to your djinn's type, you fly now, you can bring your friends into your vessel to show off your new place, and while they're in there, they can spend 10 minutes to gain the benefits of a short rest and heal a little bit. And your final ability lets you use a very limited wish to freely cast any spell of 6th level or lower, but then you can't use it again for another 1d4 long rests. I think I'm always going to miss the noble version of the genie that would tether itself to an ally and force them to never have a friend like me, but as far as the version that we've got now, I actually like it. I think that the flying should be restricted to a hover, just because 6th level free flying is a recipe for disaster, and if you want to make the ritual to get a new vessel harder to do so that players don't just turtle inside of their decorative lamp whenever they're in trouble, that's fine too. Besides that, the Genie Warlock is one of the subclasses that I am most excited to see when the next splat book arrives. And finally, we've got the Order of the Scribes, a subclass that abandoned the wizard archetype naming convention and decided to go its own route, a route that inadvertently ended up stealing a lot more from the sorcerer's gimmick than it probably meant to, but it's okay because it has a letter from the doctor that says it can. When you begin your tenure as a member of the school of the Order of the Scribe, you gain a magic marker with disappearing ink that you can use to write down spells in half the time, and you get an awakened spellbook, which is a spellbook that is not actually awakened as far as D&D term goes, but you can still use it as a spellcasting focus, which makes me wonder why wizards couldn't just do that anyway. You can also use it to change the damage type of your spells, you can cast a single ritual spell using its normal speed instead of its ritual speed, effectively giving you a free spell, and beyond that, the Order of Writing Shit Down on Paper can create a spell scroll that only they can read, and while it can only hold a spell of the first or second level, that spell immediately gets bumped up one level, meaning that the artisanal wizard basically gets another free second or third level spell slot. You are also adept at writing spell scrolls, a skill that will be swiftly forgotten about just as quickly as the alchemist's ability to craft potions. Moving on, the wizard can finally make use of the awakened part of their awakened spellbook, letting them cast out a tiny specter of the spellbook's psyche that will fly around and let you cast spells through it. Finally, your last ability lets you swap places with the spellbook spirit, and when you die, you can literally destroy 3d6 levels worth of spells to bring yourself back to life like your name was Evanescence. So while the other subclasses are pretty much right on the money, requiring only a few tweaks here or there, the Scribblenauts Wizard is also right on the money if the money was made out of paper and would unfortunately not be legal tender. This class is all kinds of jumbled up. It wants to be a papers please type wizard, but it also wants a special fun time awakened spellbook friend, and the way that the archetype goes about presenting both of these concepts seems sort of backwards. If you want to have an awakened spellbook, then you have to present that concept right up front, or else it's not an awakened spellbook. It's a my alarm went off a half an hour ago, but can I please have 5 more minutes bomb spellbook. If I were to fix this up, I'd take the Spectral Buddy feature and put it right at the beginning of the subclass, then take the ritual spell and damage type swap abilities, push them to 6th level, push the current 6th level ability to 10th level, and call it a day. Never mind the fact that being able to swap out damage types and regenerate spells should be a sorcerer thing, but they at least shouldn't be things that you get right out the gate. Also, with the extremely interesting burn spells to not die ability, the only thing that I would change is that I would let you come back immediately instead of having to wait a full
level minute, since you already have to destroy anywhere between 3 to 18 levels worth of spells, and those spells can only be returned to you by using Wish to want them back. Overall, I think that the Phantom and the Genie are good refocuses of their earlier subclass counterparts, but the Order of the Papyrus is going to have to take a lot more writing classes before it's ready to be a published author. But that'll about do it! I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe, ring the bell, click on my social media in the description below, and maybe support me on Patreon so that I can continue to support trees by using online resources instead of wasting as much paper as this new wizard subclass. But yeah, Davy out.